Hello and welcome to this Auric Warclans painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint the facial details and the teeth of the Sludgeraker Beast. Now, I'm going to be using a mix of both classic and contrast methods in this video as well. As you can see here, the skin and claws have already been painted of the Sludgeraker Beast, so just check out that video on how to do that. So the first colour I'm going to be using is going to be Bugman's Glow. I'm going to use this around the extremities of the face, such as the eyes, the ears and the gums. So what I'm going to do is get myself a small layer brush, just apply a little bit to the palette, and again, a little bit of water as well, just to thin it down ever so slightly. And then the key thing here is get yourself a nice point to the brush. So always give it a little bit of a twist, like so. And then what we're going to do is start picking out those details. So like I said, we're just picking extremities. So I'm going to start first with the gums. The other reason for doing this as well is it kind of makes the beast feel a little bit more organic when you start adding flesh tones to it. So just take your time, work your way around. If you're not sure where to place, just check the box art for details. As you can see, those extremities are now being picked out. I've also picked out the gums and the tongue as well. So what we're going to do now is move on to applying the rest of the colours. So the first one we're going to be using is Magos Purple. We're going to apply this to the gums and the tongue, and also where the claws meet the skin as well. Then after that, we're going to be using Cadian Flesh Tone to highlight some of these areas, such as the tongue, as well as the gums and the extremities. Then finish off with a little bit of Kislev Flesh as a final highlight. But first of all, let's start with Magos Purple. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. This isn't to thin it down. This is just so I don't overload the brush too much. And also, try and get myself a good point as well. Once I'm happy with that, then I'm ready to start applying it. So like I said, it's going to go on the gums first and the tongue. And when I was talking about where the claws meet the actual skin, so it's these little areas here. So it just looks like it's a little bit sore. So just a little bit, not too much. Like so. With the Magos Purple now dry, what we're now going to do is get Cadian Flesh Tone and start picking out highlights on those extremities. So this is on the edges where you've done the green skin, also on the gums and the tongue as well. You can see here I'm just doing lots of little notches instead of a straight highlight. This is to make the skin look a little bit more weathered and broken. Now that we've applied Cadian Flesh Tone, we're just going to finish off with a little bit of Kislev Flesh, and again we're just making those highlights a little bit smaller than the last ones, so you can see some definition. Now that we've highlighted it with Kislev Flesh, our facial details are done. So what we're now going to do is move on to picking out the Sludgeraker Beast's teeth. We're going to start first by using Rakar Flesh as a base coat. Then we're going to get some Skeleton Horde and slightly thin it down with Contrast Medium and coat that over. Then tidy back up the raised areas using Rakar Flesh again, and finish off with a little bit of Wraith Bone as a final highlight. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. So all I'm going to do is get a little bit of Rakar Flesh onto my palette, not too much. Also using a small layer brush here as well. So once I'm happy, I've loaded it up. Get a nice point to the brush, and I'm ready to start picking out those teeth. So there's quite a few around. Now, if you do make any mistakes, you can just tidy up with those areas around, especially on the gums and stuff, but just find all those little teeth. Just take your time. Now that we've base coated the teeth, what I'm going to now do is apply Skeleton Horde. And I've thinned this down with a little bit of contrast medium. And that's one part Skeleton Horde to one part contrast medium. Take your time and just let it roll down, get into those recesses a little bit as well. With the teeth now covered in Skeleton Horde, what we're now going to do is just tidy up some of those raised areas using a little bit of Rakar Flesh again. Again, with just two colours, we're getting at least three tones from this. With the tidy up completed, we're now going to finish off those teeth with a little bit of Wraith Bone. Just on some of these sharp points, just going to little dots here and there. And then these little molars at the back. Just pick out a little bit here and there. Get that sense of teeth. With that highlight now done, our facial details and teeth of the Sludgeraker Beast is now completed. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Sludgeraker Beast. And we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.